Imagine you've just gone on a summer vacation and want to show the route you took on a map from destination to destination as an intro to your vacation video. Using VideoStudio's proDAD Rotopen filter, you can animate an object or image, such as an animated vehicle, along a set path. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how I can map out my summer vacation around the coast of Spain, using both an animated car and a cruise boat as an introduction to my summer vacation video. Before we get started, if you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on the Discovery Center. Here you can download a written copy of this tutorial to follow along. Please note that the Rotopen feature is only available in VideoStudio Ultimate, not in VideoStudio Pro. Now let's get started. First, I'm going to drag the map I want to use as a background onto the video track on my timeline. Now click on the Filters tab and scroll down to Rotopen. Click on the Rotopen filter and drag it over top of your map image on the timeline. If you press play, you can see how the default filter is an airplane flying over the map on a set path. But I want to make some customizations here to map out my exact vacation route on this map. To modify the filter, double-click on the video clip or image, which will bring up the Effect tab. Make sure Rotopen is selected, and then click Customize Filter. A dialog box will pop up, allowing you to create a custom path. With the yellow cursor, you can hold down with your left mouse button to draw the path. I'm going to draw a path starting from the middle of Spain, down through various cities to the south, to map my route and let go of my mouse when finished. Once you let go, a preview of your path will appear on the bottom left of your screen. Now click on Next to go to the Symbol and Design options. Here we can change the way our path looks by clicking on Style under the Path tab. I'm going to choose this blue path. The preview box will pop up again to show you what your new style selection will look like. Now I want to choose a different symbol to follow this path, so I'll click on the Symbol tab, and then click on the box below Traveler Symbol. Here I can choose from a number of options, including a plane, bike, or boat. I'm going to pick this red car since I'm mapping out a road trip. If you want to choose your own symbol or image, you can click on Load Image to upload an image from your computer. Once you've selected your image, you can increase or decrease the size of the image. Now you can see my car following my path in the preview pane. But the car isn't curving with the path like I want it to, so I'll need to make some more adjustments. Go to Retrace Route and click on the box. Now you can hover your mouse over different options and it will show you how your chosen symbol will follow the path, and also the direction the car or symbol will face. I'm going to choose this one, as it will turn and follow the curves of my path as you can see in the preview pane. Now click Apply. If I click Preview, you can see the car follows my customized path, but it is going a bit too fast. To adjust the speed of the animation, you'll need to increase the duration of your video clip or image. I'm going to click on my map image on the timeline and extend the clip length by several seconds. Now, if you press play again, you can see that the animation moves slower along the set path throughout the duration of the clip. I want to add another path over the same image, but this time use a boat symbol to show how we traveled to an island. To do this, double-click on the clip on your timeline once again. Select Rotopen. Then click Customize Filter. I can see my original path is still showing on the map. To make a new path, I'll press down on my left mouse button and drag to create my new path to the island. Now I'll click Next. And here I can once again customize my style options. Click on the new path you want to customize. This time I'm going to go to Style and choose a dotted path. Now I'm going to click on the Symbol tab, and under Traveler Symbol, I'm going to choose the cruise boat. I'll go to Retrace Route and select how I want the boat to follow my path. Now click Apply. I'm going to preview my clip, and you can see that my car follows my first path to its endpoint. And then my cruise boat sails across to my final destination on the island. And now I have a great intro video to show all the places I traveled to during my summer vacation in Spain. If you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on the Discovery Center. Here you can download a written copy of this tutorial to follow along and find other helpful tutorials for VideoStudio.